Today, there are 2 million descendants of French-Canadian immigrants living in New England. These are our stories. Welcome to the French-Canadian Legacy Podcast.
Venez tous jeunes filles et garçons, je vais vous raconter l'histoire de notre immigration ici aux USA, de grands aventuriers de pays étrangers.
Bonjour everyone, this is Melody with French-Canadian News. It's a short segment today, but there's some great stuff that you don't want to miss. We'll start with a post from Ma Famille Canadien-Francais titled, Trigger Warning, Poutine is Québécois. Poutine is clearly a Canadian food, right? Nope, not even remotely close, according to the Poutine man himself. Check out why poutine should be considered a Québécois food in this entertaining post. Your host Luke is back with another episode of Les Aventures d'un Québécois, capsule number 12. Join Luke on another adventure en français. There's a new post on the Modern Franco's blog titled, Making a Statement with Franco-American Flags of the U.S. and New England. This post covers the two hotly debated Franco-American flags that were created years ago to represent us as a whole across the nation. But which flag is the better flag? And do you know about these other Acadian flags? Find out everything you need to know about all of these flags and more by reading the post. This article by Juliana LaRue gives us a preview of an upcoming event this month, Franco-American Walking Tour of St. Francis High School and College. Although this event isn't until July 24th, you can find out what to expect for this Franco-American walking tour. Moving on to podcasts, check out the latest episode of Franco-American Pathways, Episode 2, Song Keepers. In this episode, you'll hear some examples of intimate performances that appear in many of our oral histories as Franco-Americans. Listen in as this episode also takes a deep dive into Acadian musical traditions with musician Robert Sylvain. And now on to events. On July 6th from 5:30 p.m. to 7 p.m. Eastern Time, join the Franco-American Center in Manchester, New Hampshire for a virtual prêt-à-parler. All levels of French are welcome. Be sure to register for this event as soon as possible to get a spot by July 6th. On July 13th from 5:30 p.m. to 7 p.m. Eastern Time, check out the Hancock Town Library's prêt-à-parler event with the FAC. Just like FAC's prêt-à-parler, the topic changes every month and all levels of French are welcome to join. Be sure to register for this event as soon as possible to claim a spot. You can find the organizer's email address in the description if you would like to join. On July 13th from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. Eastern Time, join the Museum of Work and Culture for their Slattersville preview screening, The War. This virtual documentary screening will feature filmmaker Christian D. Resendez, who will present a segment of the film with a Q&A afterwards. This documentary segment is part of the documentary series titled Slattersville, America's First Mill Village, which will air on Rhode Island PBS in 2022. So to catch an early glimpse of this documentary, be sure to register for this event as soon as possible. Next week's guest on the French-Canadian Legacy podcast is Lisa Desjardins Michaud. Lisa is the Coordinator of Community Engagement and Managing Editor of Le Forme Franco-American Programs at the University of Maine at Orono. You have heard us talk about the amazing online events they have been doing during COVID and the yearly Rassemblement that we've been honored to present at. We thank Lisa for taking the time to talk to us about the fantastic work she does. We hope you enjoy next week's episode. That's all I've got for you this time. Everything I've covered today will be linked in the French-Canadian Legacy podcast episode description. Merci for listening, and if you're in the U.S., we hope that you had a happy 4th of July.
And then we play a bonus question that quite often does nothing at all to do with what we talked about, which is what makes it kind of fun. And one thing that's coming up a lot now, especially as we're trying to figure out what we're going to do, because we can't have a live Poutine Fest here in New Hampshire this year again, try to find out kind of what our options are. And they're actually doing a Poutine Fest in Rhode Island, Museum of Working Culture, coming up. I'm curious, and I've heard there's a difference. Did you have Poutine in your area growing up in Maine? And is there a difference between what Acadians consider Poutine and what somebody from Quebec would consider Poutine?
Yes, there are different variations of the word Poutine.
Okay.
Now, when I was growing up, the word Poutine was a dumpling that you put in your chicken stew.
Okay,
a dumpling made out of flour and water and a little bit of salt. But as I grew older, our local little tasty food or tasty freeze, I started making a poutine, which was the French fries, the gravy, and the curd cheese.
Sure.
But I'm not so sure they use curd cheese. I think they use just mozzarella.
Okay, cheating, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, but yes, but when I was growing up, poutine was not anything else other than the dumpling in the chicken stew.
That's fun.
Now our fathers look at us and sigh with despair, to think that everything they love we simply do not share. But the spirit never dies, our culture will survive. Each of us must choose how much to keep alive. Each of us must choose how much to keep alive.
Special thanks to Josie Vachon for providing the music. You can find more about her at josievachon.com. This podcast was produced and edited by Mike Campbell. If you have any questions or comments, please email us at fclpodcast@gmail.com. You can also follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at fclpodcast for more information about the topics discussed. If you enjoyed the show, please subscribe and leave us a review on iTunes or wherever you listen to this episode.